You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk those lonely seas. I'm as strong when I am on your shoulder. You raise me up to more.
We'll meet Mr. Taylor or his sister, and of course they didn't want us to pass there, but we passed. Going and coming, it was a shortcut. A lot of years passed and I did not see him or hear about him, so he had fallen off of my memory. So when I was told a few years ago to add to the list of communicants at home Mr. Taylor and Mr. Zephrine, I said, I don't know him. But from the time I entered his house, we both smiled at each other because he said, you're a Monroe. I said, yes, and I know where you used to live. And I explained, and he said, yes, he is the man, Mr. Taylor. I found him quite pleasant and open and encouraging. And I understand that he said lots of nice things about me. Okay? I went there to give Holy Communion, but you will chat a little, you know, and listen to them. You know, you don't just give communion, you just rush off. Even now that he has departed, I will still visit the home, and I'll do so for a little while. And the point I'm making is this: as he aged, he deteriorated. And I kind of looked at him then and looked at the past. And I said to myself, and I'm saying it out loud, we really don't know what we will become. Because when I started, he was strong and had all his senses and so. But as time passed, he got sick and he lost a lot of weight and he was not himself. It became a bit difficult, but I never skipped a day or a week. I went all the time. And the truth is, I'm not saying that to boast, but that is part of my experience. I knew he was going to die. Of course, all of us would die. But the last Tuesday I spent there, and I heard the things that he said, and I found that he listened a little more. Because before that, it was a lot of, you know, talking and airing out. And I said to him, and I'm not saying that as a boast, I said, prepare yourself to meet your God. That was Tuesday, and Thursday, he was a dead man. So what we see is that our role as Eucharistic ministers is to help prepare people to meet their God, not just give them Holy Communion. We don't have to tell them that, but we can pray for them to have a peaceful death, okay? The period before the death was not peaceful at all. Some people don't remain themselves for whatever reason. Sometimes we judge and we judge them wrongly. So we just pray, we give them a communion, and we leave. And when I leave, I would pray a lot for my communicants. As I speak, he is a fourth home communicant of mine that has died for the year. So I started with 7, and now I have 3. And this is no boast, so I have to be facing death very often. But it helps me to prepare for my death, meaning that I strive to live for God one day at a time. Tomorrow is there, but I don't know much about tomorrow. So I encourage all of us to let each death speak to us. Am I ready? Who do I have to forgive? What is it the Lord has asked of me that I haven't done? Am I obedient? Am I striving to do His will daily? And lots of other questions should come to our mind, because one thing I know and you know, we cannot run from death. It will come when it will come, and we cannot run from it. And the strange thing is, we do not know the hour or the time. Some people have a premonition that in a few days they will die, but the exact hour is not usually known. So I ask all of us to every day prepare as though it might be our last day, especially when we go to bed. If you have people to forgive them. If you said things that were wrong, repent, okay? Because some people sleep and never wake up. Some just wake up and barely saw the light. Some died behind the wheel. Some woke up, felt bad, went back to sleep, and they slept for good, they died. So there are so many different ways people can die, and that includes us. And finally, prior to death, we don't know what we will become. Some people walked well, they start walking funny. Some people had clear voices, it gets very hoarse. Some people's features change so much you could hardly make them out. So let us get ready. We most likely will walk that way if we live long enough. And the outward appearance is not that should be of much concern. But the soul, as regards God, where is our soul? Are we truly ready to meet Him? Have we done or strived to do all that He has asked of us? Will we have to beg for time at the last hour? I pray that will not happen to any one of us, but we'll strive, and I say strive because we have a lot to face, and we always think we'll see tomorrow. So we must strive to live good lives, have good relationships. We can't get on with everybody, but you don't have to hate and run down people. And you know the new language is obscenity, is thriving. We could avoid it. So thanks for listening. And I say about our brother who is being buried today, Mr. Zephrine Taylor, may his soul rest in peace. Amen. Okay, so now Sister Cynthia Lett is ready because Ms. Ramdani is here and she'll give us a tribute in song. Thank you. Wonderful. If it takes a song to cause Mr. Taylor to get to heaven, this one surely will get him to heaven. Wonderful, well done. And we thank God for that lovely voice and asking to sing that song. Very appropriate. And I hope you know that Ave Maria means Hail Mary. Okay? As I said, it's open before the eulogy that anyone who wants to say something on behalf of Mr. Taylor, you are most welcome. Say something, sing a song, poem, whatever. We still have some time before the eulogy. Please come forward. He has relatives here. Don't be shy, please come forward. Don't miss this chance, you won't have it again.
Good afternoon, everyone. I just want to read something to you, please. It reads, Heavenly Father, the death of my dear father has filled my eyes with tears and my heart with sorrow. I am distressed by the mysteries of your providence. As your child, I want to say I have so much to say. Not my will, but thy will be done. But at times, I find it difficult to do. Forgive me and help me. I pray you by your Holy Spirit to accept your ways as always best. Apply to my wounded heart the healing touch of your precious promises, and let me soon experience its power. Teach me not to mourn as those who have no hope. Wipe away the tears from my eyes that I may be able to see through the mist, beyond death and the grave, to the resurrection and life assured by the glorious victory of my Savior Jesus Christ, near over death and the grave. May the passing of my father remind me that I am but a pilgrim on this earth. Grant me the peace to love less and less the things that are material and temporal, and to love more and more the things that are spiritual and eternal. Teach me to number my days and to apply my heart to the wisdom taught by Jesus Christ, that he is the way, the truth, and the life, and that no one comes to you but by him, amen.
Thank you, sister. It took a lot of courage for her to do that, but she's made it. A prayer on the day of somebody's funeral could never be too much. We thank you, sister. one more person, if you have anything to say, to do, please come forward because it's almost time for the eulogy. Anybody else? Okay. So if nobody else, then we call on our sister Susan Taylor to do the eulogy. Please come forward.
Good afternoon, everyone. Stephen Jones, also known as Zephrine Taylor or Sonny, born in Dunfermlyn, St. Andrew, lived most of his adult life first on St. James Street in Grenville, and then Telescope, born May 22, 1931, and died August 17, 2023, at the age of 92. He left behind two daughters, Mrs. Evelyn Antoine Robinson, and Desrie, Mrs. Desrie Antoine Jones. He was the grandson of Craig Antoine, the long-term partner of Nadia Philip. He was also the son of now deceased Matilda Jones and David Maturin Taylor. Mr. Sonny was a merchant who worked and trade route between Grenville and Port of Spain, Trinidad. He was a wholesaler of Grenville, of goods and spirits. He owned and operated a retail store on the bay in Grenville, successfully for over 50 years, selling dry goods and liquor. About 15 years ago, as age stepped in and illness crept in, he stopped working. He was extremely successful in his business, and there was no other shop on the bay doing as well as he did. Mr. Sonny also loved the ladies, and that is all I would say about this for now. We know and understand that only his body is left here to bury, as his soul has returned to the Lord. Farewell to the life with vigor and authority. Before I am done, I want to say a thank you to all of you who are here, all the caregivers, Mrs. Modeste of Telescope, who helped him when he was much needed, when it was much needed. Ima Modeste, thank you. Ms. Jacqueline John, thank you. Ms. Alma Bain, thank you very much. We truly appreciate your help and your for our fathers. The many calls, a conversation to determine how best to help him. And so Mr. Keith Johnson, who would visit him at home, and the ladies from the church right here who visited and cared spiritually for him every Tuesday. May your kindness, care, be rewarded by the Lord himself. Thank you all.
Thank you very much. So we've learned or have been reminded, if we knew, of what the late Zephrine Taylor went through from the beginning to the end of his life in a summary form. These memories are fond memories. And when we would have left here, we'd be hearing some of the things that we heard to remind us of his past and to help us to prepare for our time. Every day should be a day of preparation, leading us closer and closer, not just in time, but in preparation for that time when God will call us out of this world. We cannot and will not escape it. Amen. So once again, may his soul rest in peace. Amen. We have a little time, but Father is here, so once he's ready, I'll find out, and then I'll be asking the family members to go to the entrance of the church so that the body can be received. Amen? So let me find out, please. Thank you. So look for the rib. It's not in basal condition. Prophet Isaiah 25:6-9. Mm-hmm. I'm start here and come to you to hear. Could you look at it again?
Okay.
Okay, our priest is here, Father, and we are asking, please, all related to the deceased, Mr. Taylor, to go to the entrance of the church for the reception of the body. And everybody else, please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Praise be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies, and the God of all consolation. He comforts us in all our afflictions, and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from him. I bless the body of our brother Zephrine, who died in Christ. St. Paul reminds us that those who die in Christ will also rise with him on the day of resurrection. May Zephrine also rise with Christ on the day of resurrection through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord our God, welcome into your presence your son, Zephrine Taylor, whom you have called from this life. Release him from all his sins. Bless him with eternal light and peace. Raise him up to live forever with all your saints in the glory of the resurrection. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Okay, the priest and the members of the family make their way up here. Please come forward, the rest of you. We are too scattered. It's a big church. We are few, and we are all over the place. So please come forward. Our entrance in is Blessed Assurance.
Dear friends in Christ, we have come here in the house of our God and our Father through the help of our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the promptings of the Holy Spirit, to perform this funeral rite for our brother Zephrine Taylor, whom God has called from this world to himself. Our brother did his best in serving God, especially our sister who normally visits him at home to offer him the Eucharist, the body and blood, the blood of Jesus Christ, testified on how well he always received the body of Christ reverently, willing to communicate with God. So we have brought him here in this same house of God, so that we may share together that Eucharist that he had always longed to receive. And so we come before God to ask him for grace and mercy, as I invite you now to bow your heads, pray for Zephrine as he journeys towards the heavenly kingdom. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant, Zephrine Taylor, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Please sit. The first reading taken from Isaiah chapter 25, verse 6 and 7 to 9 will be done by Susan Taylor. The choir will sing the psalm, that's 23, and I, Margaret Granger, will do the second reading taken from 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 8 to 13. I presume the prayer of the faithful will be done by our priest, Father Godwin. So please, Sister Susan, come and do the first reading. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. And in this mountain, sorry, the first reading is taken from Isaiah 25, verses 6 to 9. And in this mountain shall the Lord of hosts make unto all people a feast of fat things, a feast of wine on the lees, a fat of fat things full of marrow, of wine on the lees well refined. And he will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all people, and the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death in victory. The Lord God will wipe away tears of all faces, and the rebuke of his people shall he take away from off all the earth. And the Lord shall speak it, for the Lord has spoken it. And it shall be said in that day, lo, this is our God, and he will wait for him, and he shall save us. This is the Lord. We have waited for him. We will be glad and rejoice in his salvation. This is the word of the Lord.
Please. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 8 to 13. Remember the good news that I carry, Jesus Christ risen from the dead, sprung from the race of David. It is on account of this that I have my own hardships to bear, even to being chained like an animal. But they cannot chain up the good news. So I bear it all for the sake of those who are chosen, so that in the end they may have the salvation that is in Christ Jesus and the eternal glory that comes with it. Here is a saying that you can rely on. If we have died with him, then we shall live with him. If we hold firm, then we shall reign with him. If we disown him, then he will disown us. We may be unfaithful, but he is always faithful, for he cannot disown his own self. The word of the Lord. Stand.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The will of my Father, says the Lord, is that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I should raise it up on the last day.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Mary, the sister of Lazarus, went to Jesus, and as soon as she saw him, she threw herself at his feet, saying, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." At the sight of her tears and those of the Jews who followed her, Jesus said in great distress, with a sigh that came straight from the heart, "Where have you put him?" They said, "Lord, come and see." Jesus wept. And the Jews said, "See how much he loved him." But there was some who remarked, "He opened the eyes of the blind. Could he not have prevented this man from dying?" Still sighing, Jesus reached the tomb. It was a cave with a stone to close the opening. Jesus said, "Take the stone away." Martha said to him, "Lord, by now he will be smelling. This is the fourth day." Jesus replied, "Have I not told you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. Then Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, "Father, I thank you for hearing my prayer. I knew indeed that you always hear me, but I speak for the sake of all these who stand around me, so that they may believe it was you who sent me." When he had said this, he cried in a loud voice, "Lazarus here, come out." The dead man came out, his feet and hands bound with bands of stuff and a cloth round his face. Jesus said to them, "Unbind him, let him go free." Many of the Jews who had come to visit Mary and had seen what he did believed in him. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. So, good afternoon, brothers and sisters in Christ, and welcome to this ceremony of the funeral rite of our brother. Whenever we gather in this manner, we gather to express, number one, our love for our brother who is already lying in this coffin, ready to go back to God the Father. And again, we gather as a community, as people who believe in God, to pray together and to ask God for his mercy, for his kindness upon not only the dead person, but upon all of us who are still on this journey, because this is a journey. And it is a journey we all know that one day we must go. We must go. And it is a journey we must undertake. The question is not whether we are going to take it. The question is when. It's just a question of when. It is obvious to you and me that we must one day begin our own journey. So we pray for Brother Zephrine this afternoon, that as he has started this journey, may God receive him in the bosom of Abraham through Christ our Lord. Now, normally, when it is funeral like this, and when I stand after the gospel, I perform two functions. The first function is to sympathize with the family that has lost somebody. And then the next function I do is to say a word or two to all of us who are still on this journey, so that we keep our eyes focused and on the game, so that we don't lose the mark. Now, to the family, on behalf of the church, St. Andrew's, the Apostles, Roman Catholic Church here, so we want to say, accept our sympathy. Just know that the church is with you at this time. We are with you in spirit, we are praying for you, and we pray that God will give you the strength that you need. Remember the words of Job. God has given, God has taken. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So may we keep that always in our mind. All the days he lived, they were days of blessings. We are not saying that there are no ups and downs. Definitely, we are human beings. There must be ups and there must be downs. But the days of blessing were many in his life. May those days of blessings strengthen you and give you the hope and the courage to persevere through Christ our Lord. And for you, my brothers and sisters, who are still on this journey with me, we are just waiting and praying that one day it will be our turn. So the big question is, when it becomes our turn, in what state, in what stage of spiritual life will God meet us? I chose the Gospel of St. John, the Gospel of St. John, chapter 11. In that chapter, we have the shortest verse in the Bible, John chapter 11, verse 35. Jesus wept. Only two words. Jesus wept. And you begin to ask, how come the Son of God, the Almighty Jesus, had to weep? That brings the fact that, you know, when people die, and we bring them into the church, or we take them to the graveside, to the grave, to bury them. Many of us are moved in tears. Some cry uncontrollably, some cry in a controllable manner, but at that final moment of being put into the ground, there is this feeling of separation, total final disintegration that comes and overwhelms us, and tears flow. And Jesus, expressing that emotional departure of his friend Lazarus, brings to us the awareness that we are human. Jesus came to us in our human form, and he identified with us, and he was with us. He identified with us, and he was with us. And that is why whenever you look up on the cross, you see the hand spread, the spread that has been spread to say, I did this for you, and I welcome you. I did this for you, and I welcome you. So what Jesus is asking us is to recognize the fact that he has given his life for us, and he is there waiting for us to welcome us. When we come for funeral, we come with heavy hearts. But that heavy hearts, I'm asking you today to submit it to Jesus so that there will be healing in the heart. There will be healing. And when we pray for healing, we also prepare ourselves for our own journey. This journey, I always talk about it because it is a journey that when it begins, your mother will not make this journey for you. Your father is not going to make the journey for you. Nobody, no friend, no relative that will make this journey for you. You are going to make this journey yourself. And for us to make this journey, I have to explain. You know, sometimes people don't really understand what happens at death. People don't really understand what happens at death. Now, in the scripture, in the Bible, and in the spiritual world, death is a separation. Death is a separation of the body and the soul. When this body separates from the soul, then we say this person is dead. Because at creation, in the book of Genesis, the body and the spirit came together. So at creation, they came together. At birth, the body and the spirit came together. In death, the body goes its way, the spirit goes its way. Now, you remember in the book of Genesis, we were told that when God made the human person from the mud of the earth, it was a lifeless object, like a wood, lifeless object. And God breathed the breath of God's life into that body. And the Bible says, and the body became a living thing. And so, the psalmist says, Lord, when you remove your breath, we die and we return to the clay in which we came from. And that is what happens. When the breath of God, which God breathed in man, when that breath gets out of man, the man dies. Now, there are two questions that come to mind. What happens when the body separates from the soul, or when the soul separates from the body? The body came from the mother earth, and the spirit came from God, the breath of God came from God. So when somebody dies, the body will return to the mother earth in which it came from, and then the spirit, the breath of God, will go back to God that gave it. The body, this body standing here, goes back to earth where it comes from. The breath of God, which is the life that God breathed in man, goes back to God. There is no problem. The one of the body going to the earth, we understand, because when So the final ceremony that I will do at the graveyard is to take the mud of the earth and throw it into the grave, and I will mention his name, and I will say, Zephrine, you are dust, and unto dust thou shalt return. And those of you who will be standing and hearing me will say, amen. We throw the dust. The body, the dust, we go back to the dust. Now, what happens to the breath of God? The breath that God, the body has returned to the Mother Earth. And the breath of God, that spirit of God, what happens to it? It is this spirit of God that now goes in front of God to receive judgment. This body is not going with it. It is the spirit alone that goes before God. Because it is the spirit that comes from God. It is that same spirit that we go back to God. And so when that spirit comes in front of God, that is where the problem begins. Because the scripture says, nothing impure will enter the presence of God. Nothing contaminated will enter the presence of God. That is where our journey is. That whole journey we are making is to make sure that the body, this body, does not contaminate the spirit in such a way that when the spirit goes in front of God, it will be rejected. So our journey entails working hard to make sure that the body does not contaminate the spirit or does not overpower the spirit. Your body begins to overpower your spirit when you begin to drink too much. You become an alcoholic. You drink excessively. Your body begins to control your spirit when you become a gossiper. You talk. Your body begins to dominate your spirit when jealousy is part of your life, when envy dominates your life. That is when the body is dominating the spirit and it contaminates the spirit. And if the body goes in front of God in that contaminated manner, it will be rejected. And when it is rejected in the presence of God, you know what happens. And that is why I'm calling on you. Let's use the death of this man, especially family members. Use the death of this our brother who has done his part, and keep focused on God so that the body will not contaminate the spirit, so that when the spirit appears before God, God will say, come into the blessedness of your father. Come into the blessedness of your father. And that is our prayer for Zephrine today, that the good Lord who gave him life will find him worthy to bring him into the presence of God uncontaminated, through Christ our Lord. So we now turn to God in prayer as we pray for our brother Zephrine, thanking God for his life and asking God to grant him mercy. Brothers and sisters, we have gathered here to celebrate the mystery of our redemption. Let us therefore ask Almighty God that the whole world may be watered from these springs of all blessing and life. And so we pray for our brother Zephrine, that God may establish the Christian people in faith and unity. We pray to the Lord. That God may rescue the entire world from all evils of war and hatred, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may be pleased to show himself a father to our brother Zephrine, who we now pray at this very moment, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the family of our late brother Zephrine may experience the peace and the consolation that comes from God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that our brother Zephrine may be raised up on the last day through the body and blood of Christ, which we are going to share in this Eucharistic sacrifice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that all those who weep and who mourn for the death of Zephrine may find comfort and consolation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We now ask our Mother Mary to pray for us and with us as we say, Hail Mary.
Full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Lord our God, hear the prayers of those who cry unto you. May the soul of our brother Zephrine find mercy in thy presence, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Please sit. We have our collection now. Please give generously. Thank you.
Blessed, lost it, all pursued it, that's good job. Must have had a day's misery.
Please stand for the offertory and offer yourselves and the soul of the departed to the God our Lord. Our offertory hymn in the booklet, Gifts of Bread and Wine.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, whom our hands have made. It will become for us our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Pray, dear friends, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name.
Amen. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant, Zephrine Taylor, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection had dawned.
that though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful people, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Those of you who can kneel, please do so. It's a consecration when the bread and wine are going to be turned into the body and blood of Jesus Christ. Please kneel if you can.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy for these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like they do fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Clyde, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Zephrine Taylor, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that Zephrine, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us now rise together, look upon Jesus Christ our Savior, and say those prayers that he taught us as the pattern of all prayers. Our Father, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. Keep those who trespass against us, and lead us not. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always freed from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us offer one another the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away your sin and my sin. Blessed all of us called to the supper of the Lamb. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ preserve us to life everlasting.
The time has come for us to come to receive Jesus. We should be Catholic and should have prepared. So please do so when the priest stands to give you the body of Jesus Christ. Thank you. On behalf of the family of the late Zephrine Taylor, I express appreciation. Says the family, we greatly appreciate your kind expression of sympathy, support, and presence. To everyone who has shared a kind word or deed, even those who were unable to attend, we say a heartfelt thank you. May God, our merciful Father, continue to bless us all and grant us his peace. Amen.
So we now take our last prayer in the church before we proceed to the cemetery. Let us rise. Dear friends, brothers and sisters, with faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our brother, Zephrine Taylor, to be buried in its human imperfection. Let us pray confidently to God, who gives life to all things, that we will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give our brother a merciful judgment and forgive all his sins. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, lead him safely home to be at peace with God our Father. And may he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King. Your response is, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Respond, receive his soul and present him to God. Saints of God, come to his help. Come to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May the angels lead you to Abraham's side. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Give him eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine perpetually upon him forever. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Let us pray. Father, into your hands we commend our brother, Zephrine Taylor. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave him in this life to show your care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Christ Jesus. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our brother to paradise and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ to be with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Zephrine, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and the eternal Jerusalem, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. The Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Our recessional hymn is "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." Refreshments afterwards by Peter Bain's place, business place. Refreshments after the funeral at Peter Bain's place. Thank you. Thank you.
Brothers and sisters, we have come to the final resting place of our brother, Zephrine. And so we do the final prayers. We start by blessing the grave. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you. And even though their bodies lie in the earth, they trust that they, like you, will rise again. Give our brother peaceful rest in this grave until that day when you, the resurrection and the life, will raise him up in glory. Then may he see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, in the kingdom where you live and reign forever and ever. Since Almighty God has called our brother Zephrine from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth from which it was made. Christ was the first to rise from the dead, and we know that he will raise up our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. We commend our brother to the Lord. May the Lord receive him into his peace and raise him up on the last day. Your response is, Lord, hear. Let us pray for our brother, Zephrine, to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. The man who believes in me will live, even if he dies. And every living person who puts faith in me will never suffer eternal death. Our brother, Zephrine, was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord. Lord, you wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow, we pray to the Lord. You raised the dead to life. Give our brother eternal rest, we pray to the Lord. You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother Zephrine to the joys of heaven, we pray to the Lord. Our brother was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give him fellowship with all your saints in heaven. We pray to the Lord. Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our brother, Zephrine. Let our brother be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord. Our Father, just a minute. I will use it. And lead us not into temptation. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. For without him. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May the soul of Zephrine and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Zephrine, as you begin your journey, remember that you are dust. Amen. Yeah. Let's go. Mm-hmm.
welcome. What a friend we have in Jesus. Can we sing? What a friend we have in Jesus. The last page. What a friend we have in Jesus. The last page. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. We do not carry everything to God in prayer. Temptation is the trouble everywhere. He should never be discouraged, seeking to the Lord in prayer. So faithful, who will all our sorrows share. Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. How we can heavy burden comfort with a load of care. Once we think we are still a refuge, take it to the Lord in prayer. Take it to the Lord in prayer. When the Lord is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll let's call up yonder. When the roll is call up yonder, when the roll is call up yonder, I'll be there. Through the night of gloom, through the sweetest youth of the golden morning, rising my soul.
The golden morning is fast
approaching,
Jesus will
be here. Oh, the wisdom, the golden morning, passing through the night of gloom. Oh, the secret of the morning, morning, passing the freedom inside the morning, in the night of gloom. For the freedom inside the morning, in the night of gloom. Oh, the sweet heavens at the morning dawning, blessing to the night of gloom. Oh, the sweet heavens the morning dawning, blessing to the night of gloom. To the night of gloom,
for we see the gleams of the morning
of the night. Sweetest sound that set our rest like me.
Praying.
Right now.
Leave him alone. I have a banana. Leave him alone.
So let's take the final prayers. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, listen to our prayers for our brother, Zephrine. As he always desired to do your will, so in your mercy, forgive whatever wrong he may have done. By his Christian faith, he was united with all your believing people. Now in love and mercy, give him a place with your angels and saints. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you. Thank you very much and God bless you all.
Amen.
Thank you. Well done. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Why it should be first for the Lord? Why there are others living among us, never molested, doing the wrong. Father alone. Then we could wonder why others prosper, living so wicked year after year. Father alone will know all about it. Father alone will understand why. Cheer up my brother. Sunshine, we'll understand it all by and by. Faith will to death set our living master. A few more days to labor and wait. Souls of the road will then seem like love. Father alone will know all about you. Father alone will understand why. Cherub
sunshine. We'll understand it all by and by. When we see Jesus coming in glory, when he comes from his holy sky, then we shall meet him in that bright mansion. We'll understand it.